not one to break promises. I don't want to hurt you, but I need to breathe. At the end of it all, you're still my best friend. But there's something inside that I need to release. Which way is right? Which way is wrong? How do I say that I need to move on? You know we're headed separate ways, and it feels like I am just too close to love you.
Excited?
Very excited.
How about you, Tom?
Yeah, excited.
Thanks,
sir. And it feels like I am just too close.
Well, it's 8 in the evening. We've been driving for 10 hours now. We've just arrived at Ferry 2 of 2, the Giron Ferry, which will take us over the river to Sur-Lac-sur-Mer, and that's where we'll be starting the kayaking journey tomorrow. Two guys, Zach and Tom, will be doing that. It's been a long, old journey. We're tired. We've been up since 4 in the morning. But it's great to be here. It's really fun to see the river finally and see what we're actually going to be, well, they, I say, are going to be rowing and kayaking in. So, wish us luck. We'll speak to you later.
You know where we are with Tom's
horse. There's nothing to say, nothing to do. I'm nothing to give. I must live without you. You know we're headed separate ways.
Okay. Don't worry
about that. And it feels like I am just too close to love you.
Looking happy.
Very happy.
Very reassured.
What's just happened?
We've just arrived at our set off point and it looks very calm. And well, can you see for yourself?
Stunning. So out there is the Giron.
We found our mascot. We haven't named him yet, but we just come across this little guy in the middle of the road.
Most incontinent person.
Yeah, we've met today. Oh, oh my god.
So I'm on my way.
Zach and I am one of the canoeists, and we have just arrived at our campsite for the first night. We set off from Guildford this morning very early, and we've now arrived south of the Gironde in Sur-Lac-sur-Mer, and we are just about to enjoy dinner, and we're all very grateful to be here and looking forward to going to bed. We've also found a great spot to set off from for tomorrow, and yeah, we're really excited now, so looking forward to getting hopefully a good night's sleep and starting fresh in the morning.
What do you think is going to be the hardest part of this challenge?
Well, it'll kind of have the weather, I guess. The weather could be really against us, and if it gets too hot or too stormy, obviously, on the water, that could put us back. But I think mentally, probably just getting ourselves through the miles, knowing that everyone else is probably having quite a nice holiday.
What made you actually want to do this challenge?
Oh, well, it's all for Help Heroes, and there's not a more worthy cause out there, really. So, you know, we just want to do as much as we can to show them that, you know, there's people out there that want to help them for helping us. And that's about it, really. That's enough incentive for us to do hopefully pretty much anything if we're fit enough.
Good stuff. Do you think this will be the last sort of challenge you'll undertake like this, or do you reckon this is going to be the first in a long line?
Right now it feels like it's probably, it would be nice if didn't have too much for the rest of the year, but no, there's already things in the pipeline, and this will probably be the beginning of a lot more to come.
Good stuff. Thank you, Zach.
Cheers.
Hi, we're here tonight, finally at the campsite. I'm Tom, running with Zach, who you already heard from. Finally we're here, as I say, and tomorrow morning, less than 8 hours to go.
Are you looking forward to it?
Crazy challenge ahead of us. Yeah, absolutely. It's going to be fantastic.
Despite the grueling challenge ahead?
Grueling challenge, yeah. Exactly. It's going to be horrific, but at the same time, absolutely brilliant. The Gironde is absolutely stunning. So placid. It's amazing. But it just, it's all dependent on the weather, on how we cope, how the bodies figure it out.
Do you reckon that'll be the hardest part of this challenge?
Could easily be. It depends. I mean, if we're looking at 27 degrees, as we could well be, that's going to really change the game completely. If it could just be as little as going over one route too many, a little twisted ankle, could be a game changer. Who knows?
And I'll have to stand in.
Yeah.
So what are you looking forward to tonight? What's the plan tonight?
Just really simple things. Getting a bit of food down us. Good night's sleep.
We have
to try and not think about it too much. Yeah.
There you go. Thank you very much. We'll see you bright and early at 5 o'clock.
You will.
Introduce yourself, please.
I'm Sarah.
And what is your role on the Cockleshell Heroes Challenge?
My role is support. Probably mostly cooking and washing up, to be fair.
Excellent.
And administering first aid, though it will not be required.
Good stuff. Are you excited about the challenge?
I am very excited, very proud.
Good stuff. How much do you think we're going to raise?
Oh, I reckon you'll hit at least crack the 3,000, but if we could get up to 5, that would be pretty magical.
Excellent, good stuff. And why did you want to come along?
I just like being involved in things, but just to offer support to everyone, really.
I'm Howie Craggs. I'm me, basically.
What's your role on Cockleshell Heroes Challenge?
Ham and cheese.
Ham and cheese is your role?
Yes.
What's your actual role?
Mostly driver, also campsite supervisor, organiser, whatever you like, basically.
General handyman.
I have to make sure that people have somewhere to sleep and eat.
Brilliant
in
stuff.
The evenings.
Are you looking forward to this challenge?
Absolutely. I'm already looking forward to it, yes.
What do you think the biggest part of the challenge will be for the guys?
Just keeping tabs on the guys, making sure they're okay, especially when they're underwater. One of the biggest challenges is getting here on time.
Yeah. Brilliant stuff. And how much do you think we're going to raise?
Hope we'll get the full 5,000, if not more.
Hello, I'm Jess. I am Zach's girlfriend and probably joint main chef with Sarah on the trip. Making sure the boys are well fed.
What are you cooking tonight?
Tonight we have spag bol.
Beautiful.
Which is actually looking fairly tasty, which I'm quite pleased about.
What are you most looking forward to about this challenge?
Cooking lots.
Excellent.
Seeing the boys succeed, really. I think it's amazing what they're doing. And for them to be able to have the achievement at the end of it, it's going to be incredible. So anything I can do to support them on that, that's my main goal.
Good stuff. What do you think their hardest challenge is going to be?
I think it's going to be the run, the really long run. I think that's going to be particularly hard, especially after the 2 days of kayaking. So I'll be interested to see how they get on with that. But that's what we're all here for, to make sure that they get through it.
Cool stuff.
So we'll do our best.
Excellent. So you've heard from everyone else, but not from me. Well, I'm Ben. I'm going to be basically filming and tweeting the whole event live. You know, Zach is one of my good friends, as is Tom, as is the whole family. I really want to do my bit and just join in on this great event. You know, it's not a holiday. It is a charity event. It is a challenge. So it is nice to, you know, get away and see France, but also to just, you know, raise as much money as we can. Which I'm really looking forward to. So yeah, tomorrow morning we're going to hit the Gironde River at about 5 a.m. We're going to head southeast down to Bordeaux over about 40 miles, if not more. I'm going to try and follow in a dinghy. I'm going to try and keep up with the lads in the canoes, or kayaks I should say, and see where we get to. So I'll be filming bright and early, and I'll see you then. Don't forget to follow us on the Twitter, which is at cockleshell2012. And of course the Tumblr, which is cockleshellheroes2012.tumblr.com. All the videos will be posted up there, and we'll see what we can do over the next 4 days. Wish us luck, and thanks for joining. Bye.